will now conduct the troubleshooting scenario. For the final 15 minutes of the defense during this session, we will present you with the problem identified by the panelists. Just like the previous scenario, we will provide you with a set of slides to provide the information on the scenario, and then the panelists will pretend to be customers, this time experiencing a problem. Please use the whiteboard to walk through the troubleshooting scenario you would use.
All right, so based on the problems that have been reported, there's a couple of things that I want to go over in regards to not only the connectivity of what we have, the diagram of your infrastructure, but also performance-related stuff to see how if I can derive to some sort of solution. Mm-hmm. So one, I can notice that on the network side, obviously, the connections are not redundant. So is this a true mesh network or not? Is it fully redundant? What's the deal there?
It's supposed to be fully redundant.
So that's one thing we can kind of notice, that the network is, you know, in terms of availability, in terms of the availability of the network, there's something that we can consider there. Obviously, there's been reports of remote connectivity dropping.
So in that some VMs, correct.
In some VMs, right? Correct. Is that just on the VM? Is there a network outage somewhere?
Some VMs are, some of the applications actually on the VMs, they lose connectivity because they run databases and they time out.
Okay. So I think, okay, so it could be that the problem is just communicating because of the network, there's too much traffic on the network, there's some sort of disconnection there. Well, there's something to consider here in regards to the connectivity of the physical devices, but now if we look into, for example, the virtual machines and the virtual switches of the infrastructures, how are those switches connected? Are we dealing with standard switches? Are we dealing with distributed switches?
Since this is 3.5, I think we are still in the standard switch.
Right, so okay, switches. So it's just standard switches only. Now, the configuration of the switches, are they single, multi-home?
They're multi-home.
How are the adapters configured? Are we all active-active? Are we passive configuration?
They are active-active.
Okay. So you have multiple, at least two in each?
Correct.
Okay. So virtual switches are configured with multiple NICs. All right. So let's just do that. And have multiple NICs. So now to the factor on the virtual machine. So I want to move a little bit out of the network side. I want to talk about some of the what's happening to the VMs and the outages. Looking at the connectivity on the physical network here, there's some things that are sort of come to mind. So for example, do you have enough? Is there enough capacity in terms of bandwidth? Have you oversubscribed or not?
Correct. So we don't see any packet losses.
Okay.
And there are no very little minor network collisions.
Okay. So how about in terms of these tier one sort of type of applications and the ones that are accessing data and dropping? Is this a matter, are you having high disk latencies or something like that? Is that what's coming back?
In the host that's running those VMs, we see such latencies.
Okay. Okay, so let me note this high storage latency. So thinking about the high latencies in these types of applications, so what is the failover policy that you have within the arrays of configuration, the VMware failover policies within?
Can you define that again?
So the vSphere infrastructure has these the pluggable storage architecture for storage, which the pluggable path selection plugin is a feature that allows you to choose what happens if one path were to fail, right? What's the configuration at that point in here?
I believe it is the one that we use for, can't remember right now.
Sure. I would have picked that up right there.
I think it was, it's an active-active array.
Active-active array.
Which should require
active-active.
One active-active type, and we're going to give them that it's configured the wrong way.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's
what is that called, man?
MRU?
Yeah.
MRU.
Okay. So we'll take a break, and then I'll let you go ahead and run.
Right.
Okay. Go ahead. Ask the question again.
So what type of array do you have in terms of the and also the path selection plugin for the storage level? What type you have selected there?
The array is configured in an active-active. And for the failover, we have considered most recently used.
Okay. So why you see most recently used? Is there any specific that drives to that configuration?
When we started out the design, this is what the previous consultant recommended.
Okay. Were there any requirements to adhere to that specific recommendation, anything specific?
Not that I recall, but what we wanted to do was we needed for the VMs that were running, mm-hmm. the applications that were critical for the users, mm-hmm. we needed those to be with lowest latency possible, and they get the best performance. The SLA required that they give us the best performance.
Okay.